capsular contracture and the defeat of this complication is the so-called holy grail of breast augmentation surgery. What happens is when a foreign body or a man-made object is put in a human being, it doesn't matter if it's a breast implant, a pacemaker, an artificial joint. In the first week, the body makes a layer of tissue around it called the capsule. That capsule is the patient's own tissue. Now, that tissue can sometimes start to contract down and harden. When we put in a breast implant is not shaped like a baseball or a sphere. It's shaped like a dome. And we put it, there's only one correct position for it, and that's to be centered under the nipple and the areola. If capsular contracture ensues, what happens is it starts to contract down and it changes the dome into a sphere and draws it upwards. Most of the research seems to implicate bacteria that's normally found in the breast itself or on the skin. If it contaminates the implant, develops a process and produces what's called a biofilm, making it resistant to antibiotics and white blood cells, which is why it can be difficult to treat just with antibiotics. We do know that contracture rates seem to be related to bacteria contamination on the skin, that the same bacteria that everyone has on their skin, as well as within the breast gland itself, if it lands on an implant, acts differently than just bacteria within your body. It forms what's called a biofilm, which is like a slime layer that protects it from your white blood cells attacking it or antibiotics. That's another thing that our practice offers is the aspirin after surgery treatment, in that if somebody starts developing a contracture early, treating it with antibiotics as well as an anti-asthma medicine that was serendipitously found to help women with hardened implants, as well as high-dose vitamin E, has been the standard non-operative treatment for capsular contractures. But we only got a success rate of about 30% with it. The aspirin after surgery treatment is something that we offer. There are about 9 centers in the United States. And what it does is add ultrasonic energy also to the contracture, the implant, to try to break up the biofilm. And then with that, we're getting success rates of 80 to 85% resolution without having to reoperate.